This conference will now be recorded.
National meeting regarding the fiscal year 2023-24 budget. About this time, I'd like to ask Pastor, Mr. Bullock, do you mind saying our invitation for us tonight, sir? And pretty believe it's in our family.
And Father, we come before you once again. We thank you for the opportunity you've given us to be a part of this grouping. And Father, we thank you for giving us the opportunity to serve the citizens of Bladen County. Father, continue this watch over us. Let us make decisions that's good for all the individuals, not just specific people. Father, we thank you again for giving us this opportunity. Bless the commissioners, all the employees under the sound of my voice, and give us great time here, Father, so that we can come out ahead in your business. Father, we thank you again for giving us this opportunity. All these blessings we ask in thy name, for Christ's sake, amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Mr. McKinney, you got a hot chair now.
This new chair.
Now my feet don't reach the ground.
Thank you so much. You ready to run away?
No. I'm trying to look over.
Mr. Martin, the floor is yours, sir.
All right. Thank you. Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you for taking time on this wet afternoon. I just wanted to begin by reviewing that there are several changes that really not very many on one page. These are changes since the last budget. I mean, since the proposed budget. And we talked about some already, but we have increased revenues in health and couple of the JCPC and those types of things. We've reduced revenue for BCC deputies, and this is one thing I want to talk to you about. This has come up since our last, this last week, if I'm not mistaken. But the sheriff's office is going, has been in conversation with Dr. Lee at the community college about transferring the two deputies who have been working at the community college and placing them at schools, particularly like West Bladen, and then would come back and check on, you know, stop by BCC periodically throughout the day, because there's also an early college, as you know, at the community college. And so we fund the community college. They have a budget, we have a budget revenue back from the community college, and then the positions are budgeted in the sheriff's office. So this basically does away with the two transactions from the the revenue back from the community college and the so the money would still be going to the community college. And I've talked to Dr. Lee just this afternoon, and they want to use those funds for other types of security or whatever. So it's really a net zero to the county. We still continue to fund it just like we have. It's just that those other two transactions wouldn't take place.
So you're saying that nobody at West Bladen right now? No police officer.
No, I'm not saying that. I'm saying they've had challenges in filling some of the school positions, the school SRO positions, and so these two who have been working at the community college would be shifted to schools. And I'm not sure if the specific two would be.
Okay, Chairman, they're board. The FRO is assigned West Bladen, and FRO is assigned to Dublin Elementary. Is within a mile of the college, and they would take turns checking on it periodically during the morning and afternoon. And Dr. Lee is fine with that. And
so those two positions will go where?
Well, we'll put it up school for the first time. We'll be full. Y'all want six new positions last year, and you can't fill them. And I believe we'll have one open in gym
after August 1st.
After we do this, we'll have one open in SRO.
That's good. Okay.
First, I'm asking Greg, I'm trying to figure out which one of these figures is he public safety? And I see. John, which funds are you taking the money from? Is it $143,000 or $127,000? Which one is it?
There's a slight variation because the two positions that are at, who are the two individuals who work at the community college are not beginning type deputies, whereas the budget was for beginning type deputies. So there's a slight variation in that. But the funding would still be provided to the community college.
Can they use it for capital outlay?
They can use it.
What I'm asking, like, they're asking for allocation for capital outlay. Can they apply this to the capital outlay?
Well, they're actually they were actually asking for a higher appropriation for current expense. We funded the capital outlay in full.
This is real worried. What would they do?
Current expense. Yes, sir. But they're indicating they want to use it for public safety. I mean, Dr. Lee indicated on the telephone she wanted to use it for public safety, so I'm not sure about all the details.
But what amount?
That same amount they've been receiving. Okay. Yes, ma'am. So again, it's a net zero to the, I mean, it doesn't change anything in terms of our
appropriation. Because who are the police officers on SROs that are going to school? Are they going to be beginners? Or are they going to
Well, that's the only slight difference. That's the only, that's the only minimal difference. The difference in what they're currently making versus what a new deputy would make. Is that correct? And then would you say that's right? Yeah.
About how much money? What are we talking about?
It wasn't that much. I think it was like $1,500 or $1,800.
No. Okay.
Okay.
So then there have been some, wanted to mention one thing, and Lisa helped me. I'm glad that we're being thoughtful on this. You all will recall that the Division on Aging has had a vacant, has had a vacant position that we are not, that has not been filled. So we know that because we received the block grant funds in a lump sum amount, we'll be required to pay back a portion of that next year. And they do it, so that would be for this year. They true it up and then we have to do, you know, that whatever. So we're going ahead and being mindful to appropriate funds to be able to do that for next year. So it's basically going to be in our fund balance at 30th of this year, but we'll have to pay it back after that. So that's why we're going ahead appropriate those funds.
Why didn't we promote that lady that's going to do it sooner so we don't have to send so much money back?
Well, we've eliminated
the one that was in the place. Well, she was in an in-home aid position and she was working as an in-home aid and then she got sick and came to the office.
I thought it was from like Kent's place.
And that's in Barton. That's Bob Barton.
Oh, okay, I'm sorry.
That position's been vacant. That we're proposing not to fill that. We're eliminating that position.
So that's the one I thought you were talking about.
No. We're eliminating that position for next year. And then the Parks and Recreation, the $41,595, that's the additional position that was approved at the last meeting. So anyway, those are the changes in, so far. And then moving to, we've tried to prepare some information, and Lisa, I appreciate her sharing this with you last week, just so you'd have an opportunity to review it ahead of time. But we wanted to cover a few of the items that were topics of discussion at our last meeting. One, and I'm looking back and looking at this handout now on the second page, the lower chart. And that pertains to the sheriff's office parking lot, the additional parking lot that was requested. You remember there was discussion at the last meeting that the price had come down from $250. I think the estimate originally was $250, and now it's $140. And so I just wanted to share that with you all. Again, that's one time. That would be a one-time appropriation. So,
great. That's the first thing. When we were appropriating this money for the parking space, does that reflect that you had it coming out of fund balance, when you go take this forward?
Well, it wasn't in the proposed budget. No, sir. So this will be an additional item for you all to appropriate it.
So there'd be some additional, so we never put it in there with it.
No, sir. But since then we told you about the reduction. Yes, sir. Also, this came up a week or two ago as well since our last meeting, and that is the sheriff would like to increase the part-time appropriation by $58,500 to add a third telecommunicator for peak, at certain peak times. Is that
correct?
Which would be overtime, using overtime.
Part-time.
I said part-time. Yeah, it will be using overtime existing telecommunicators to fill in during peak times. as needed. And so that's an additional $58,500 requested there as well.
When is the peak? Do you mean nights or hours or holidays? What peak do you
think? Most times it'd be like 2:30 to 11:00 or 2:00
hours.
I think on this one, we're looking at 4 employees, right? 3 full-time and 1 supervisor.
We look at 1 employee.
So you're talking about having 1 additional employee or just not using that $58,000 this compensation for overtime?
Right.
Is it cheaper to do it that way?
It is, and we're going to check with our personnel. They would work it if you're an opportunity. Those range is not looking cheap.
I just wonder what it's cheap. I was looking at my cost. It's cheaper to work it that way.
It's just about, the cost of overtime is just about the same as the cost when you add benefits. The one advantage to this is it gives a little bit more flexibility. It's more of a variable cost as opposed to a fixed cost if you had a full-time.
You don't have a training. Well, it'd be cheaper to be part-time, but then you don't know what hours you're going to work.
I'm just having the amount of money stuck in my way.
Your hours are going to work, it'd be different, but you don't know.
And then moving over to page 3 of the slide there, this is just information you've seen previously. I just have it included again. We do, on the lower slide, we know a little bit more than we did the last time we met because Cumberland County, for instance, has proposed their budget since then. So Columbus County information we shared last time was 3% COLA. Cumberland County has proposed a 4%, and I think they've adopted their budget right now, but a 4% COLA and also set aside money for a pay study. Robeson County, 3%. Sampson County is doing a pay study. The town of Elizabethtown increased law enforcement officers, their police officers, pay by $6,000. And then fire, they did a 3% COLA plus an increase for certain certifications. And then other employees received a 3% COLA.
I'm sure I'm figured this, does that bring Elizabethtown Police, is they overtaking your guys, or is it bring about the same scenario? Who's the head of the gang on that one?
The only difference between us and them, what get does is that they get money for education and for when they receive their certificate, advanced certificate, and we don't do that. So, will it affect? Probably.
Okay, I just wonder if they're going to be leaving going
they,
over.
They now. Were they eligible for our educational programs?
If it is for class to pay for tuition reimbursement? Yes. Mr. Cogdell, if you flip over to the next slide on page 4, that top slide there, the town of Elizabethtown that was showing at the time that starting police officers $38,000. So then if you add 6 to it, it's going to get them to 44.
Well, now guys are at what?
Right. Currently they're at 42.
Okay. I mean, they got to make some more movement.
Well, no, this is before you.
I was trying to make sure we was in line because he'd be complaining about people taking the staff. I was just trying to make sure that he was being competitive. That's all we asked for.
If we were to do the 5% for deputies of Blaine County, they'd be at $44,100, and down this town would be at $44,000, and White Lake's going to be at 46 or 47. With Derrick School, what did they say they get buried 3%?
2.5.
Yeah, I mean, they're going to be at 46 or so, so we're still going to be behind White Lake, everybody.
You should stay in line, so we want to come in and start bumping things all the way off the chart. That's what I'm trying to say. Trying to keep up with this local competition right here in the area.
And then the lower slide on page 4, EMS, shows this is the information requested during the last meeting. It shows nearby departments, nearby counties, and you can see that. We're competitive on basics and intermediates, but on paramedics, it's a competitive field. And just to remind you again, Sampson County has done a pay study. It's not completed, or it wasn't a month or so ago when they were proposing the budget. So that $40,000 figure will, I'm sure, will be adjusted during the year whenever they.
But with the work load, the number of cases that they would work during the day from Cumberland County versus Blaine. I mean, they'll be working those hours, but they're not really doing.
Yep, if you look at the workload, it probably ain't gonna be a whole lot different. They got a whole lot more trucks and people running than we do. Ain't gonna make a difference. What I think we need to focus on this year is you're looking at our paramedics at $44,000, 706. Robson County's at 48. We're $4,000 cheaper than Robson County.
And that's because Robinson County, remember we shared some information, they did their phase study, right. I think, like in November or December.
Sure, that's why they got the raise.
So that's when they, right. Last year, I'm just saying, when we were having this conversation last year,
yeah.
we were going to be in a competitive.
We knew that, yeah, but I still like to have a case show during the day. I'd like how many they run a month.
Never
can compete with them.
It's high, so we can't keep up nowhere.
Oh, okay. And then move the ball.
Well, you're not going to, you're not. It's
not really.
You need to get a little closer. We all.
I agree. Oh, I'm not. Oh, yeah, I'm saying. I was just saying, I mean, if
we
got the
business up there, and we've been using it a long ways, but trying to get more. Need to get a little closer than $4,000, I think.
Let's give him 5%.
That's the one that he's having most difficulty trying to staff. That's the one he's having problems trying to staff.
How long have they been here? Most of our paramedics, have they been here long?
A number of them are on a beast, appear to be on a beast debt, which means between, 1 year and 5 years.
So I guess
that's not all
inviting
me. I'm just saying that we have.
And they, I would, especially ones who stay. I would really reward those.
But I think, is that one that's suffering? Yeah. Right now? Is he having problems getting that staff? That I hear them say about those guys.
They're short. You ain't hard to say.
I thought it was short with just the basic.
Yeah. My recommendation to the board, and I've thought about it, and I know it's a constant battle for EMS, the Sheriff's Department, and all, but we've got a nation that's gone through a whole lot, and we all have, and law enforcement, it's just hard to get them, regardless wherever, due to what we face in our nation. My recommendation would be up the paramedics, $4,000, and 5% to the Sheriff's Department, and 3% to our county employees, to try to get everybody in his line as close as we can and continue to still not try to raise no tax. That would be what I'd like to see.
Chairman, I'd like to distribute some information regarding COLA to the commissioners and Mr. Martin, and I'm looking at 5%, but after I did some research, let me share with you what I have.
Sure.
I guess my question is, how much are we starting to dip into our fund?
Oh, I'll get ready to see what kind of figure we're looking
at. We haven't done anything budget-wise outside of one-time up.
You don't have calculators on 5%. This on straight 3.
But Mr. Chairman, what I mentioned in a prior meeting that I thought the COLA should go up to 5%. But I have a presentation here wherein a survey was done throughout the state of North Carolina, and the data was collected between, you look at the third paragraph on page 1, the data was collected April 3rd through April 21st. And when you look at this, he has it on the board here, the 24 COLA data is this page, this screen here is by population. And Bladen County falls into section E up there. And You see there, the according to the population and the data that was collected in North Carolina, the average for the population like Bladen County is 4.4%. And the high end is 8.8. I'm not, well, you can't do that. But I was hoping that we could at least hit the average there for the for 4% for the employees in Bladen County. They need more income, and I think it would be to our benefit to, plus two, we found out that Bladen County is like a training ground, especially with EMS. I don't know about the sheriff's department, but with EMS, they learn, get their abilities here, their training here, and then they move on. So we need to look at what we are paying our employees. And I think our employees deserve more than 3%. As I said, they're throughout North Carolina, that you can see A through F on the screen there is by population. And Bladen County is in the section E, which is the population between 25,000 and 99,000. And there's 4.4%. So I think we should move the COLA up for all the employees to at least the average.
This is well, I totally agree with you. I like to give a whole lot more. But when the citizens of Bladen County wouldn't even vote a quarter cent to help pay for SROs, I'm wondering how concerned those that voted no are about our employees.
I have no idea on that.
Well, that's
I know it was a no, you're right about that. But Commissioner Peterson just said let's get closer. So this 4.4% would get us closer.
Don't speak for me now.
No, I think you just said that.
No.
Didn't you say that?
I'm comparing it to local counties.
I know.
I'm declaring it to the state of North Carolina. This could be Cumberland County. This could be New Hanover County.
Yes, sir. But I'm saying your words. Your words, and let's get closer. So I'm using your words.
With EMS. EMS. But that half a million would sure help.
I support all of it.
Right here today.
I supported all of it.
Even county employees need more.
But I do think we should. I do think we should give them more than 3%.
Lord knows I'm as big a proponent for the EMS and the police as anybody. I guess my question is, are there any of our other departments that we know what other counties are doing? If we're thinking about that, just our clerical people, our janitorial people, whatever. If that's our criteria for helping EMS and police based on what other counties are doing, do we have, and that's easy to figure out more so than maybe the other jobs, but. You know, that's our mindset. We're going to try to keep up with surrounding counties. Do we not do that with other jobs as well, I guess?
My thinking is,
yes, sir, absolutely.
I was looking at this. I've heard the thing about three, and I was talking about it. They went to, five. But my thing is, if the fund balance, we know what's going on. And I'm trying to figure out, Ms. Coleman, Ms. Martin, we don't have no idea what that would look like. I'm saying you're sitting there talking about proposing something, but we don't know what it looks like. We know what 3% looks like.
Yeah.
But even with the scenario that Mr. Britt gave, if you did a spread across the 4 or 5, what would that be the fund balance for reoccurring costs? That's what I'm saying. Because all this is reoccurring costs. What would it look like if you went into it with reoccurring costs? That's the thing we always be concerned about, reoccurring costs. So,
what we do is what I do is what I can't say what we need to do because I can't speak for y'all. But you've got to do what you think's right. Forget about the fund balance. It's reoccurring. You just do what you think is right and don't worry about the word. There's plenty of money in fund balance. The only thing you got to worry about, the things you do tonight in raises is going to come back every year, and then next year it's going to be even increased because you've got to do it next year too. So they ain't no need to worry about that. That's just my opinion.
We did run information as far as 5% for law enforcement and 5% for EMS. Remember, we have an amount that's in the contingency that is equal to 3% across the board. So that's already in the proposed budget. So an additional And of that, for EMS, the 3% is 121, no, I'm sorry, for the sheriff's office, for sworn officers. The amount is 121,000. To go from 3% to 5% is an extra $80,952 for the sheriff's office. So $80,900. So it's $202,000 for that 5. Because their payroll for sworn officers is $4,045,000. So each percentage is, you know, approximately $40,000. Now, on paramedics, we don't have anything showing $4,000, but I know that there are 23 paramedics. That includes, that's from David, that's from the supervisor through the, that's from the department manager, department head, through the supervisors to all the paramedics. It totals 23. When you just look at a 5% increase, again, 3% is already budgeted, that would be an additional $27,542.62. To do the $4,000, I'm just doing it in my head. 23 times 4 is 92. So that'd be a total of 92,000. 41 of that is already in the proposed budget, again, because three per an amount equal. So about another 50. That's right.
To get you within $584. It has to be a 10% increase for EMS. 10% will get you to $48,694, and Robson County will be at $49,000.
That would be 10%.
Okay.
And you already got 3 in there. 7% if you can get them close to Robson County. And that's where a lot of I wish David was here, but that's where a lot of our workers work overtime, and they come here and work overtime.
Your part-timers come from over there.
Right. Yeah, my thing is, if we having any issue with retention of any other employees, personnel back there, we having any problem with other retention with any other employees wanting to need more money? Yeah. We have to go straight across the board, and it's not those two parts of it.
Yeah, Mr. Chair.
It's going across the board. Those two guys are going across the board.
Yeah, but I think all those folks, I mean, every department, every employee will feel the pinch of the economy. Foods, entertainment, everything else. They're suffering as well. They too need to receive at least 4%. We only get one population. Population and we say, oh, them. I understand. I support the sheriff and the safety folks. I support that percentage. But I also know that other employees deserve more as well. They suffer when the same economy. They are suffering. So they too need to have at least a
decent. I'm saying, I don't think nobody's against.
Then let's increase that to 4% for
us. We're just talking right now about it. I heard nobody say that.
Not only is that what the retention. Yeah. Going on with, because I see a lot of people coming in and retiring all of a sudden. I'm saying you have a problem refilling those positions at the rate of pay we got.
DSS is a challenge.
DSS
has
a challenge.
What have been the COLA the past couple of years?
5%. For 2 summers ago for last fiscal year, 6% last summer for this fiscal year.
11% 2 years, and the year before nothing because of COVID, because they were scared about COVID numbers.
But they got
maybe for one or two.
I did 450. Yeah, that's right. We did a one-time bonus.
That's right. So 6% last year, 5% the year before.
Well, Mr. Bree, where the numbers are now?
Yes, sir.
I'd like to make a motion. $4,000 increase for EMS. Okay. 5% law enforcement, sheriff's department. 4% for the county employees.
I second that. That's good.
And a motion is for any further discussion?
Yeah, the discussion, when you get passed on paramedics, I wish we would run some numbers and stuff before we do it. I'm not against any of that. But you really need to see what you're voting on. Because when you get by 27C, and then you go to 30B, there's $6,000 difference in those two employees.
when you go to when you go to the director, there's $16,000 between him and the next employee. And to give, and nothing against David, but give David $4,000 more, you're going to have him at $79,000. And then you're going to create problems with other department heads.
You got that right.
We need a workshop on it, I think. Yeah, I'm not against it, but you need to look at the numbers because I've done these numbers today. I've been working on numbers all day trying to figure out this stuff.
I think we need to work the numbers on.
Well, because you'll put him with the
government. David's 74 now. If you give $4,000, he's almost a 79. What's that going to do to his other department heads? Where there's already $16,000 difference between him and the next person in EMS.
It would be the 3%. If he's at 74, the 4% would be 70. 74.
You didn't say that, Greg. He said $4,000.
Yeah,
I know what I was doing.
But he's
looking at the difference between 4,000 and 4%. If you're talking about 4% for all other, that would be 76,960. So the difference.
You're talking about department heads.
I was talking about David.
David at 4%,
right.
Everybody else.
That'd be good.
Right. It's separate. Yeah.
And that would be almost $3,000.
Yeah. I go along with the one. I think we need to write the numbers so we can see them.
Okay.
So everybody can see what you got. But I was looking at people leaving.
I'm not against it.
I'll be honest with you. I'm leaving out.
Just for round number purposes, I mean, we can come back whenever you want to, but each percentage, again, is close to 250. Not exactly, but it's close. It gets close.
Everybody about the same.
Okay. I'm talking about benefits.
Let's take a recess. You run the numbers, and we can look at it when you come back in a few minutes.
Before you do that,
though.
But can I ask you, before you do that, I have
to.
So let me ask a question, though, before you do that. Yeah. Now, you brought about David. Not a problem, what you're saying, but I agree with that. But it's not just him. It's all the department heads. They get more. Their salary already up here. So while we don't want to go anything different, you're saying you don't want to give them 4% or the, you don't want to give the David, but it shouldn't get the rest.
Well, I said it won't give David $4,000.
That's what I mean. Though.
I think it will create other problems in other departments.
Right.
But I can be wrong. I can be wrong.
But I think we need to look at the difference from department heads. I know you earn your money. I'm not against that. But at the same time, when you look at how we pay you guys, your 4% could be $20,000 versus somebody else, $500. Well, it may not. I don't know how much electric, maybe $1,000.
That's going to say great day.
Hey, well, some of yeah. Yeah, he does. No. But I think when you look at that, I'd like to see the head, department head different.
How much time do you think?
Another meeting.
Can't come back to another meeting and do it. Well, if they can do it now, it's 6:30.
We'll run over there.
Okay.
Call another meeting.
Let's be sure we know what you want before we walk over there. EMS, we know 4,000, we know what that's 92,000 plus benefits, so we can figure that out quickly. Deputies, we know what the 5%, that's already on paper. And then just add one more percent. I mean, that's going to be about 2. Yeah, we can.
And I like to give between the department.
You got to remember. You don't look at the department head the same thing. I mean,
I'm not going to go against them.
The only thing we keep talking about, and of course I could be wrong, but every county, call Wake County and see if they have retention problems, and they do. Call Union County, they've got problems. Mecklenburg's got county. You know, we got to stop kind of using that as every, you know, we got to do it or else we're going to go somewhere. Everybody's going everywhere else. Call them. You don't believe them, call them.
Like
the case,
This conference will now be recorded.
All right. We have tried to provide this information in a way that's easy for you to follow. The first thing is EMS. You have a sheet that has two sides, you know, two sides. If you want to start with the side that has paramedics listed, you can see the existing salary of the starting paramedic and then what the total is for the 23 paramedics, as well as the 3%. And the reason we're showing that is because the 3%, an amount for that is already in the budget. So keep track of that. And then the $4,000, what that represents. And so you can see that, or what the 4,000, what it would get the salary to. And then you can see what the total amount is. You can see that the 3% is 41,000, the 4,000 is 117, and the difference over what's already in the proposed budget is 76. And then a similar
business. So, Craig, are you saying, what you're telling me is that this is a 3% increase plus $4,000?
That's right. The 3% increase, the reason we're showing that is because an amount for that is already in a contingency line item in the proposed budget.
So, is that
so it wouldn't 41? Be net new.
41?
That's the 41,000. To do the 4,000 is the 117, so the net increase is 76 over what's in the proposed budget. And then a similar scenario for the sworn officers. A deputy sheriff, you can see what that will be, get it 44. And then you can see that the 3%, which again is already in the proposed budget, and earn amount for that if that's what you want to do. And then you can see what 5% is and the difference.
So where is the general population 3% to 5?
On this.
I'm sorry.
Oh, hold on. We did 3% to 4.
4%.
4%. Yes, sir.
So we had the reason, thankfully, good Lord have mercy, we had a similar slide like this showing 3% from the original budget. So you can see these figures and you can see what the total is with benefits, 987, which again rounds out almost 250 for each percentage. Then you can see the minus the DSS contribution from the federal government, less solid waste and water, which are two other separate funds, less the sworn officers and paramedics, which ties back to the 80,000 and the 60,000.
So the sworn officers 401k is totally separate of what they do in their pay. It's totally separate.
And that 162
revenue. I like it. I have
$40,000. Okay, you're talking about 676 plus the 80 plus the 76. That was then. How are you getting it? So we're talking about all of
80.
162 should be a plus.
We're talking about
162 should have been a plus, right?
Did I get it wrong?
I said 40.
Yeah, it should have been a plus. 162, 7.
No, I'm having to subtract it off of this page.
Because we were already showing it on this one. We were trying to make sure we didn't count it twice.
Yes.
And then we were thinking fast. Now we could either help us double check this because we were getting a little bit.
So you showing the figure on one page that's showing the increase, but then you're showing the less off the full sheet.
Right. Yes, sir.
So you got to reflect the two different places, but it's the same amount.
Right.
When you get through, you actually add all of it together. That's the amount of increase for both of them, consistent both of them.
Right.
Okay. I see.
Well, hold on. But here's what we're saying: it is that everybody is 4% of everybody was in that first number. That's what we're trying to make sure.
I understand. Okay. And you get that.
Well, I'm telling you what.
That's the duration of 162.664. It's already on the other sheet showing on the other sheet. 80.76.
So you're looking at about $825,000. If we do that.
It went up
3%. It went up how much?
Oh, yeah, 20.
29.5.
22, 23.
800 something. We're talking about doing how much?
65.
Greg, does it, if you do a lump sum versus the percentage, does that affect the pay study thing a bit, or is it better than the percentage?
Either way, that doesn't really.
Yeah, yeah, Mr. Chair, while he's still doing that, I was looking at to look at the fact that the ones that she was telling me, we still have people in the county making $29,000. I think the environmental is the lowest. And why don't we consider giving them an additional percentage? And that will put them, they'll still be in poverty. Okay, how you look at it, they'll still be in poverty. Up until 80, or at least $7,000. And then those between the 75,000, the 120, give them 3.5%.
Reoccurring costs would be 800.
Because that way, I know you don't like it, but I'm just saying that you can give 4% to people make 120,000 or 80 some thousand dollars. And then, and they'll still, these folks at the bottom will still be in poverty. They will never be ahead of inflation. They still go up. We talk about how we care about our people, but it seems like we only care if it looks right. We're not saying be equal, we say equitable.
There is, do these reflect, there is, job responsibilities will pay,
yeah.
And there's job titles will pay.
Yeah.
And everybody's not going to make the top dollar, but you don't penalize people, the top ones, to bring the lower skilled people up.
No, it has nothing to do with that. Equity does not mean you get the same. It means that at your level. Well, you're saying it's a penalty, though, when you do equitable. That's not
that.
I thought you said I was not penalizing.
You're penalizing someone no matter what you do.
No, you don't. You think so.
If you're talking about across the board?
No, you're not penalizing them because equity means you give them where they are. I didn't say where they need to be. I said give them the difference. Give them the percentage wherever they are. So if you're at the lowest value, if you give them 4% or 5%, they get that $1,100. $1,300 maybe, but they won't clear $1,000. You put somebody who's making $100,000, they're 4%. That $4,000, they'll clear $2,500. I'm not penalizing them. I'm just saying, give the ones at the bottom something more. That's all I'm asking.
Can I ask a question? And I'm looking at this chart right here. Yeah, I know you're gonna get to it. I want to look at. She's stopping this 4%, and this chart you gave us here, is this every department here where the black stops is where they are at, they brought themselves out? So is that with the 4% tax on?
That's current.
So you have to tax.
All we did, remember, just to reiterate, we just included a lump sum amount. We didn't distribute it in any way just to you all, because we really hadn't had any real discussion about how you all want.
So everybody here got 4% too? That's
no,
the
no,
that's
just the, no, that's how things are.
Yeah.
Current.
Okay, but
they'll be, he will say, well, they'll be subject to the.
No, I'm saying that 4% in this total you gave us on this year.
Yes, yes.
It's in here.
Yes.
What you gave these guys is calculated, even though it's not showing on.
That's right.
So you have to add 4% to each one of these things where it cap out at. See, that's what it means.
Because I understand what Dr. Lawrence says. We had this discussion last year, and I'm just trying to remember, because we said we wanted to make sure nobody was below a certain amount. And didn't we do something last year that brought
$15
an hour? Okay, I knew we did something. I just, you know, and I get
And unfortunately, that's just life. I mean, that's everywhere you go. If you go to Walmart or anywhere else, the manager's making a whole lot more than the stocker, and the stocker might be working harder than the manager. You don't ever know, but it's noble. I just don't know where do you draw that line, because at some point you're going to have that line that somebody says, well, you know, I think our goal should be help the folks that are on the bottom to work their way up so that they have, you know, that they have opportunity to advance. And hey, if I hang in here by next year, I'll be in a different position and all that. I think that's sort of the American dream, not necessarily to pay somebody just to stay in that lower position. Does that make sense?
Well, I'm not going to go anywhere. I understand that. But I was telling him, the largest employer in the United States Army, United States, still have our folks in tears. We got paid in tears. And we didn't complain. We tried to move up, keep the years to get this raise, or get promoted. But everyone, they tried to give the ones at the bottom something different. But you're right, they'll never catch up. They never will. But we gave them something different. They qualify for other programs and some money.
Mr. Chairman, my motion still stands as it was. 4% for all employees, 5% for law enforcement, and 4,000 for paramedics. Then we have a second by Mr. McGill.
Any other discussion on that?
Did we have clarification on the director?
Yeah.
So $4,000 for him as well.
That's going to put him in a different category.
Yeah, that's fine. Let's put him in there.
Okay. It's going to be different. He needs to be a
4%. Well, why are we going to pull him out?
He's doing the same thing as everybody else.
He should not be penalized because he's getting closer to the rest of them. If they grumble, you're saying it's okay. But it's not okay for the little people, are the ones who are making less than $40,000.
Well, I think the issue was that he would be more.
I don't mind that.
But this, am I seeing it? It doesn't look like he's that much more than the library director or any of the others.
Man, he got 4%. It'd be the same thing.
I'm going to give him $4,000 handy for change. I say give him
right here. That's what I'm saying. $4,000. That's what I'm saying. I think we were thinking he was making more. Because that, if you add four to that, that because
he's making that right there.
Hold on.
Making 71.
So
he's making also 74. He got 71.
Yep,
going up.
Going up in July.
Going up that why steps.
Okay.
Yes, that's
what that was.
But that still puts him about equal with the building inspector. But
is anybody else going up on this? Did you guys look?
I mean, we just ran them. We didn't have it. We just ran the sheet that we had.
I got questions about
the director with, to me, a whole nother level of responsibility.
I say
is he considered an employee or is he considered EMS? That's my question.
I'm good. In the working paramedics. I said, maybe 100% like all the rest.
Made the motion on vote for.
You got to clarify that because there's two thoughts on that.
Yeah. 4%, like everybody else.
Why are we going to separate? He's still a veteran.
All the other department heads get 4%.
But he's also a paramedic. It's amazing when we pull him out. That's not right. It's not right. He's a paramedic. If something happens, he is certified as a paramedic.
That's in the vote. What's in the vote?
What's in the vote?
$4,000 for paramedics,
5% for sheriff's office, 4% for all the county employees.
So what are we classifying to direct that? The paramedic?
He's a paramedic.
So he's going to be classified as a paramedic.
Okay, good enough. As long as we're clear.
So all the paramedics get $4,000.
All the paramedics get $4,000.
Yes, sir.
And when they leave, we'll start all over.
Yes, ma'am.
Because I think we should give the retention money. It's much better to keep it here instead of just giving the money straight out. They get the percentage, but give them the $4,000 for retention to stay with us for a while.
All right, gang, let's move on this thing. All in favor, say aye. Or I'm sorry, all in favor, raise your hand.
I'll wait. Because I want
any opposed?
angle.
So I make a motion, we approve the 2023-24 budget.
I'm taking that for my name.
I have a motion, Mr. Peterson, second, I'm going to give you to approve the 2023-24.
That is right, 2020.
2023-24.
Yeah.
All right, all in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Second.
I want my presentation to be included in the minutes for today's meeting.
All right, sir.
Mr. Chair, Mr. Chair, can I ask that we get the, because I'm telling you, Mr. McGill brought it up again. I didn't think we had anyone below 30.
I'm going with that concept.
I'd like to see what our kids feel.
Be a fair bid, be a fair bid.
All right.
After this 4%.
Yeah, with the 4%, after 4%.
I thought we did well last year.
All in favor?
Aye.